guys? GPLS1 here, and we are at Offshore Hardcore Free For All. Oh, First Blood, look at that. That's right. This game, this is the map I told you that I was going to... This is what I call monitoring an area, not camping, but you can call it what you want. I don't really care. I'm going to play the game how I want to play the game, and that's just how it is. You see this helicopter pad right there? I pretty much stick to it the whole time. And these guys just kept on coming, so I'm going to stay here and kill them, you know? Oh, I just went right by him. Whoa. But anyway, on the last video, I got cut short because I was running out of time. Hardcore is a little different. You know, you're going to play Hardcore Free-For-All, you got to either... I mean, it's hard. I mean, bullet damage is like twice. It's not like just normal where you can have 4 or 5 hit markers on certain guns. It's... Normally, it's 2 hits, you're dead, if not 1. I mean, you don't have your radar. You don't know where they're at unless you have a spy plane. I've earned a spy plane. It's just harder. And I like playing hardcore because on just normal gameplay and core or whatever, I don't like putting a clip of ammo into somebody and they just stand there and look at you and shoot you in the head. I can't stand it. It just... You know, I know it's a video game. This isn't 100% like real life, but I mean, come on. 4 bullets in your chest, you're not going to shoot me back. But in Call of Duty, you can. And that's just how it is. So I choose to play hardcore. Now, I used to hate hardcore. My brother, he got me into it, and I just about won't play nothing but. I don't need that radar. It's not necessary to me. I see what's on my screen, that's what I go after. That's just how it is. There's my helicopter. My chopper's doing some work. And I've learned playing these maps and my experience with Modern Warfare 3 this whole year that this map is like the absolute hardest. And it's you know, attack helicopters. There's so many in and outs. I mean, you could have 2 attack helicopters and have a pretty safe game. It'd be all right. So, other than that, this is my house. Yeah, I make my way back to the helicopter pad, and I just kind of go back and forth here. Now, you could call this camping. I call it camping when you're sitting in a corner, you don't ever move, and that's what you do. To me, that's camping. This is more monitoring. I'm watching both these walkways. Oh, there's a guy. And, you know, I'm just making sure nothing's getting up here to get me. I just thought about something. I could walk that pipe, I bet. You know, and I just, to me, this is not camping. I should not have thrown that grenade. There, he got me. And I was standing on that rail like an idiot, too, so. But I really think that there's a difference between, you know, watching an area and camping hard. I mean, you're going to camp a corner and wait till people walk by every, you know, that's camping. That's, you know, I am moving around. It may not be in a very big area, but I am moving. Kind of just control this side of the map, or this end of the map here. I don't know what that is all about. And I just kind of go back and forth here. Now, what do you guys think? Do you think this is camping? I personally don't. Now, the guys I was playing against called me a camping asshole a few times, but you know, I don't care. I got the win, so. He got the drop on me, didn't he? And even when it spawns me on the other end, I make my way back to that helicopter pad. I just choose a path, I go there, and that's how it is. So, the next video, now I said in the boardwalk video, I'll have some kill confirms, some high action kill confirms. Look at this guy, watch this right here. Watch this, guys. This is good. Oh, stick your head out. Oh, yeah. So anyway, I got some kill confirm games coming up. They'll probably be up sometime this week. I'm only going to have time this weekend for these 2 free-for-alls, so, because I want to keep playing. You know, if I play and then I edit and play, then I edit, I kind of lose my groove. So I'll probably edit the, you know, after I get these edited, I'm going to want to play. I don't want to keep editing all day. I can spend all day editing Call of Duty stuff. I don't want to spend all day doing it. I get going in a groove, you know, I want to keep it going, so. You you'll see in my kill confirm, I'm not. I don't sport the PP90. I've got a different gun. That's right. You guys will see what that is. I'll save it. Those of you that do know anything about me and my gameplay, what kind of gun do you think I switched to? Submachine gun or assault rifle? This ought to be a given. Somebody like Polaris ought to know what I'm going to pick. I don't ever roll with light machine guns. I don't ever roll with snipers or shotguns. I just don't do it. Assault rifles, submachine guns. I've only actually got four classes set up right now. I just prestiged again, and I've only gotten four set up because I haven't. The only assault rifle I really like is the ACR. But I do have a SCAR class, and I got a CM90 or 901. What is that? Whatever that CM900 or 90 or whatever that gun is. I've got it kind of leveled up a little bit. But the SCAR, I was playing some kill confirm with the SCAR the other day. And I'll tell you what, I was knocking people down. I was impressed. I was like, really? Why haven't I used this gun before? You know, it doesn't have the speed of any kind of submachine guns, but the SCAR is a decent. I mean, if you like prestige, or you just started playing Modern Warfare 3 the other day or something, and you don't have the ACR yet, go with the SCAR L. That gun'll get you by, and it'll put them down too. As you start getting proficiencies and attachments for it, you'll see what I'm talking about. I'll probably keep it in a class. I was actually doing pretty good with it. I mean, not near as good as I do with these submachine guns because I like to spray the lead, but. See, every time I make my way back over. Ooh, look at that guy. Make my way back to the helicopter pad. I'm really just now learning my routes here. And I've got a couple routes on the other side of the map that I just run a circle. Ooh, here we go. He gave his position away. But on the other side of the map, I actually have a route that I take, and it pretty much completes like a weird circle, and I will sit there and I will run that thing the whole game and just get kills like crazy. It's like, really, guys? And so I mean, this map, I'm pretty confident I can do pretty good, and that's even not camping. Or see, I just called it camping or monitoring or watching a certain area. If you're actually going to run, you know, I've got a couple routes already laid out, and I can sit there and just run them all the whole game and get kills. So I'm not sure where I'm at. The one thing about hardcore sucks, there's no notification of time really unless you hit start. Be nice if I had a little clock up in the corner, you know, let you know how much time was left. Yeah, I'm sporting that PP90 pretty good. I'm laying it out there. There's my second helicopter for this game. That's pretty good, guys. I mean, you're playing hardcore. You gotta think about that. You're on hardcore. You're not on core. Oh, I did him dirty. He just spawned. But, you know, I am playing hardcore. It's a little different, guys. You're gonna die. I don't care who you are. Hardcore. There's seven other people on this map, and the rule applies to everybody. You know, more bullet damage, no health regeneration. You're gonna get killed. You're not Superman on hardcore. You know, you get hit, and he's far enough away where it's gonna take more than one shot, and your screen goes red because you're bleeding out. Your screen stays red for a long time on hardcore. It doesn't like come back within like 2 or 3 seconds like on core. So I don't think I get the final kill in this, but I do take the win, so that's cool. But it's just a quick look at offshore. I know I didn't get like the whole map in for you. There's another whole side to this map that's, you can self-contain yourself there and do the same thing I'm doing here and be just as, you know, if someone was on the other side of the map monitoring that area and I was over here, We probably have a fight for first place. Look at this guy here shooting me in the ass. I think that was the final kill. It was. But look who's on first. That's right. Check this out. Look at this guy. I would have done the same thing, but look at that. Right in the ass. Look at that. Like, really? Anyway, guys. Next video, kill confirmed. That's right. Catch you guys later. Thanks for watching my Call of Duty videos, and please subscribe, leave comments, let me know what you guys think. If you want a certain map, I'll gladly go play it, and we'll, you know, just speak up. Talk to you guys later. Have a good night, day, whatever time it is. See ya.